I'm Justin with Brandastic, and on today's video, I kind of want to go over on the methodology and thought process on actually sales. Should you be teaching people, educating them to get the sale, or hard selling them instead? You know, in my opinion, teaching, I'm more of an educator, so that's my style. Some people are really good at the hard sales. I'm personally not, because I just like more of the relationship styles as my tactic. And actually, I think if you present an owner or a company with all the data and the information, the obvious answer is going to come out to them of why the what you're trying to show them or sell them on is going to work for them or not. And you know, with all these online activities going on, the average time someone spends online is about 10 to 12 hours a day, like their whole day, not just work, but outside work, people are on their phones. So how do you grab, as someone that's selling a product or service, how do you grab people's attention, you know, and what do you communicate? And so that's what I'm going to roll in today on how to actually reach them. A great example of this is Airbnb. You know, they create a thing called city guides that allows travelers to find things to do in the areas they're going to travel to. So if people can find great things, there's great content around, like place to eat, place things to do with their kids, they're going to book that travel with Airbnb over everywhere else because they have all these things that they can do, a guide to help them book their trip. So another fun fact is that actually content creation is 62% less expensive than advertising from HubSpot, and also 3 times more effective. So just think about that when you're creating that educational experience around your product and services. Number 2 is answering people's questions. This is really simple, but really effective, because really it shows you're just engaging with your customers, your audience, and people that are following you. One big thing is, like, if you have a blog with a way to engage with people is really great. Another way is if you put a YouTube video out, making sure you get back to people on the video. This shows your expertise in the field and also allows people to interact with you, engage with you, and ultimately trust you more. And the fact of the matter is, people buy based on trusting others and trusting that you're gonna do what you told me you did. One really cool example of this is Marcus Sherday, and he actually is a pool install guy, and he answered everyone's comments that they ever left, answered everyone's questions, and was really good about it, and his business grew. Check him out online. I'll probably put a link on the bottom of this video. But just, you know, my goal for you today is just take that hour or two or a couple minutes just to answer people's questions. And now it's easier than ever because you can answer most people's questions just right on your mobile phone. Number 3 is just share your industry news. Everyone has a bubble. Everyone's in a bubble in their industry, and they're dedicated to their industry like a sport. So just share the data, share the MLB stats, the RBIs, the hit records, whatever it is for your industry, share it, because people love the data. They love catching up on things. And if you can share more of that, you're gonna be more relevant in your space. A really great example of this is Charles Schwab's Investment Magazine, which went out to their customers every month, educating them and keeping them excited about investing in the market. I hope these 3 ideas were helpful to you. I know I love learning about my industry and sharing that information with my customers and everyone I know. So have fun, make it a good day, subscribe to our channel, and we'll catch you soon.